careful about making rash decisions. You already have contracts with two other crafting guilds. You'll need to cancel one of them if you want to work with us.
Stratus Empire rewards those who serve with distinction. One at a time.
Hey there, friend. I'm a little busy having a genuine panic attack right now. Come back later, yeah? Oh, Gil must have sent you. That's great. You're just in time to help me make the lightning fire. That'll really impress Pochung, the head potter. Let's start by talking Ploggles. The Ploggle Chiefs always summon the lightning sphere for us, but they've been captured by these mean striped Ploggles. I tried talking to them, but you know how Ploggles are. Anywho, if you could free the Ploggle Chiefs and bring me back the lightning sphere, I'd really owe you one. Do it for old Chunsen. The Latin Sphere? Hot plog! Sorry, been spending too much time around the ploggles. Alright, now get that to the charred tree. Yeah, the tree over by the Great Kiln Gate. The one hit by lightning and all burnt up. It's the only tree that can hold lightning and fire. Put the sphere into the tree and the lightning fire will flare up. Light a torch with it and take that on down to Pochunk. He'll be so dang happy, I bet he'll give you just about anything.
So that idiot Chunsam roped you into doing his work, huh? Well, at least preparations for the Kiln Festival can continue now. What, you think lighting a kiln will make me hand over the Potter's greatest creation? You should know a Potter is not so easily impressed. You've wasted enough of my time. I have countless tasks that need doing before the Kiln Festival begins. Be gone from my sight. If you are truly desperate, I suppose you could get the mandrake sprouts. The old drunk Jackden can explain how to get them. Don't disappoint.
Thank you. acquired a new quest item.
Are you? Never mind, I don't care. Go away. Mandrake sprouts? The Kiln Festival is here already? I hate the Kiln Festival. The potters, the lightning fire, the pots. I hate all of it. It's dull and stupid and boring. They don't even drink. Right. The mandrake sprouts I grow can fuel the lightning fire for days. In return, I get all the soju I can drink. Pots and pots of it. It's the only thing worth living for. But mandrake sprites love the smell of my sprouts, and the potters won't go near those floating creeps. No mandrake sprouts, no festival. So I need you to toss a banishing orb at those mandrake sprites. They'll go wherever it is they go and leave my mandrake sprouts ready to pluck. Easy as ploggle pie. Check the stone lantern at the Mandrake Grotto. Should be in there. Oh, and watch out for the ploggles. Now leave me to whatever I was doing.
Yeah.
The mandrake sprouts.
These will keep the lightning fire lit for the entire kiln festival. Ah yes, the crest. Well, the truth is, I don't have it. Potter legend says Mushin commissioned the silver crest thousands of years ago. It now rests with his descendants, the Mu family, in Clear Sky Village. As if it's that easy. I'm sure the silver crest is still in Clear Sky Village. It's a precious thing made for Mushin himself. He was once a great general of the Naryu civilization, you know. How would I know? This all happened a potful of centuries ago.
Colonel Yankai oversees this region and likely maintains records of Clear Sky Village's population. I heard he's currently visiting a military post not far from here. Go bother him about the Mu family.
How fares your search for my Mushin's legacy? I don't see you presenting it to me, so surely you're still hard at work. Forget all of that. You should be focusing on finding Mushin's legacy. Find Mushin's legacy, or people die.
We have a problem. I found Jewel at the Great Kiln. She's been asking around about the Mu family and asking if Mushin had an heir. She threatened Pochung, the Chief Potter, and he told her about Clear Sky. He said some of the Mu family settled there centuries ago. I went to Clear Sky to keep ahead of Jewel. I asked around about the Mu family, but came up with nothing. And now you're here. Are you looking for Mushin's heir too? So the heir could live in Clear Sky? That's a problem. The village moved supplies for Yonkai and the Grimhorn attacked their caravan. They kidnapped some villagers, so there's a good chance the Grimhorn have the heir too. They don't keep them, they eat them. If any captives are still alive, they'll be in the Grimhorn Scullery or the Altar of Champions. You go to the altar, I'll go to the scullery.
A dynamic quest has begun.
Some would-be hero, huh? I don't care why you're here, just don't get in my way!
Wait, do you work for Yunkai? Listen, I'm grateful to you, but I want you to send Yunkai a message. Tell him that Clear Sky Village will no longer move his supplies. It's too dangerous. That woman Jewel asked me the same question. The Mu family died out during the Talostratus War. There are no more in Clear Sky, or anywhere. The Mu family was known as a clan of warriors, but the war was long and costly. All of them died except for Yasana, who was with child. But after the war, Clear Sky was attacked by mysterious assassins, and Yasana was killed. They found her body near Lotus Lake. Her infant daughter perished with her. A lotus flower marks the spot where Yasana fell. Some people claim to have seen her spirit wandering there. Her spirit still lingers there because she was not properly put to rest. I've tried myself. There are too many Grimhorn. Will you please find the lotus and bring her spirit home? We need some time to get our wits back. We'll meet you at Clear Sky later.
So, Mushin's legacy. Do you have it? Of course they do. Zhongwan wants to be a tough guy. That's fine. But it will cost him. 1 out of every 10 men in Clear Sky. That sounds fair, don't you think? I'll have my most ruthless men subject them to new worlds of pain. I'll show them carnage they can't fathom. Now find the damn legacy!
Thank you.
There wasn't anyone named Mu at the scullery. Waste of time and bullets. You find anything? A lotus, huh? That lake is cursed by the Grimhorn. It's gonna take more than moving a flower to free her spirit. The Grimhorn's charms make them immune to the curse. Collect some and maybe we can help. Get the charms, and quickly.